How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. This is another Fusion short tip one. This is about shortcuts and toolbars a little bit. This is not the end all say all to shortcuts and toolbars, but this is the ones I use and they are very handy to be able to have. Up here you have the upper toolbar, and these may be the default ones that when you downloaded the program. Well, if you right-click on one of these are called panels, first off, each one of these here, titles, these are called panels. You can right-click on this panel, and you can reset panel customizations if you've screwed it up. You can remove the panel from the toolbar, which might not be a good idea. And you can reset all toolbar customizations like we just did, or show all hidden panels. Well, none of mine are hidden right now. So most of the time when you're looking for a command, you can go up here, you'll click sketch, and you have all these commands. Now, if you downloaded the PDF for the shortcuts, which there'll be a link in the description for the PDF to off of the Autodesk website, you can download that and print that out. It's very handy to have right by your computer. It's all the keyboard shortcuts. But if you don't want to use that, you can do some other options here. So you can click sketch, and you'll see some of these have an L by them or a T. These are the keyboard shortcut for it. It's already being designated. But you always notice these little three bars. They're dots, I should say. Now, let's say rectangle. Now, that one has an R, and there's the three dots. Let's say I want this one, the center rectangle. I use it all the time, let's say, and I want that one. Click on those three dots. Those three dots will give you some options. You can either pin it to the toolbar, you can pin it to the shortcuts, or you can even change the keyboard shortcut designation. This can be very handy if you're a left-handed person where you use your mouse on your left hand and your keyboard from the right hand. So you could swap things around if you want. So here, let's pin it to the toolbar. And it shows up in the toolbar. And like I said, you could easily change that and get rid of it or reset this customization if it's the wrong thing. And you can add a bunch of them. Now the other shortcut is hitting the S key on your keyboard. And what pops up is model shortcuts. Now wherever your mouse is where it's going to pop up. If I'm over here, I hit S, it's over here. So if I hit S, it's over here. This is what makes it super handy, is that it's right on your cursor already. So I'm going to hit S, my model shortcut comes up, and I want to add the circle icon to it. So I type in a search, circle, C for circle, typing in your search, whatever you want, whatever you're looking for. There's center diameter, and if I click on this little arrow, it'll add it right to the shortcuts. Now, whenever I hit shortcut, I have circle, and I can just click on circle and I'm ready to draw the circle. Or in my case, I have extrude, fillet, create sketch, center rectangle, and circle. But I can add a bunch of these on there. But it's a very handy search option where you can just tap like rectangles. Well, that didn't get me rectangle, but EC that gets me all the rectangles. So with one hand on your keyboard, you can do a lot, and to get to the shortcuts, I should say. All these things are really helping your speed at which you draw, and you spend less time searching and things like that. It's very helpful. So download the PDF. Link is in the description. And thank you for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thanks.